Hi, I'm Gary McAdams with Barbara Anderson Realty. Today we're taking a look at the Phillips Villas. The Phillips Villas are pretty unique properties for the Villages. I like them a lot. One of the main things that makes them unique, as you'll see on the ride out here, is they're kind of surrounded by nothing. You have about a quarter mile driveway on the way out to the villas themselves with nothing but green farmland, fenced in, well taken care of, well preserved. One of the many great things about the Villages is they really take care of their community land around your home. We'll have the occasional kids out doing their donuts and leaving skid marks in the intersection, but I think that's going to happen anywhere. With the Phillips Villas being in Marion County, it's very unlikely any of this land on the ride out will ever be developed. It's all owned by the Villages. But the new development is happening much further south in Lake County and Sumter County. It's been said by the Villages development offices that they're not going to do any more building in Marion County. So what you see now is most likely what you will see forever. Even though the homes are roughly a quarter mile off Highway 42, you'll notice there's still a large privacy wall. This helps a lot with the noise reduction. Looks like someone's getting a delivery from Amazon. As we approach the gate to get in, you'll see it's just like any other gate anywhere in the Villages. Standard key card for entry. All the residents are issued a key card upon closing on your home or signing a lease if you're a renter. Please excuse my fumbling with my gate pass as I try to open the gate. I don't have NBC's technology. I'm trying to hold my camera, hold the steering wheel, and open the gate all at once. Once through the gate, you'll see all the beautiful Villages landscaping you've become accustomed to. We'll make the corner and let's look at some of the Phillips Villas. They're really great homes. The villas in here are the more upscale villas compared to some of the others you might see. They're all concrete. They have a nice one-car garage, a relatively large driveway. You could easily get another car, possibly two cars or a car and a golf cart in the driveway after you put one in the garage. There's plenty of room. One resident of the Phillips Villas told me that they actually fit a car and a golf cart inside the garage. They said it takes a little finagling and they have to be real careful coming in and out with either vehicle, but they've been doing it for quite some time and they haven't had an accident yet. I really like the landscaping you'll see here in Phillips. It's just enough to make it attractive, enough that each house can be unique and a little bit different, but not so much that it becomes a project. So many people come down and they have these grand yards and now you've got a whole new job once you've retired. I know for myself, I like my yard looking beautiful and my yard at my home looks very nice. I don't at all mind doing some yard work. It gets me out in the fresh air. Gets me some exercise, I chat with my neighbors when they walk by, I make it a fun afternoon. That being said, I don't mind spending a couple hours a week working in my yard, but I don't want to spend a couple hours every single day. The other option, of course, is you can hire a professional landscaper, but then that cuts into your budget for other things you may want to do in the Villages. We see that they all have beautiful landscaping. Now let's talk about the actual villas themselves, the actual house, the structures. They're either three-bedroom, two-bath, or two-bedroom, two-bath homes. On the small end, they'll be about 1,300 square feet. The bigger ones go up to about 1,700 square feet. They have a nice patio and yard in the back. The patio's enough to, you know, have a table and chairs, be able to have your grill out there, sit and eat. A few of them have a small pool in the backyard. The back porch is a screened-in lanai-style porch, although some of the owners have opted to have glass windows put in and kind of make it a three-seasons room, or sometimes you'll hear it called the Florida room. I have been in courtyard villas in Phillips as well as other communities in the Villages where the owner will run the AC ductwork out into the Florida room, making it actual air-conditioned living space. Gives you a little bit more living area for your villa. The question everyone wants to know is, of course, price. The villas in the Phillips Villas and most of the courtyard villas over in the older section of the Villages will start on the very low end in the low to mid 300s. The more expensive, fancy decked out ones will go up into the mid to upper 400s. I have seen one or two go close to 500, but that's extremely rare. Pretty good rule of thumb is if you figure anywhere between $350,000 and $425,000, you'll buy yourself a very nice home in the Phillips Villas. This is a great little community, very close to the grocery shopping, pharmacy, the medical facilities. The Spanish Spring Town Square is just a few minutes away by automobile or golf cart. There's several really nice restaurants very close by. One of my favorite restaurants in the Villages is the Lopez Legacy Pool Bar. That's maybe 5 minutes away from the Phillips Villas. You'll notice a nice rec center. The pool has a really good sunset view. If you want to preview any of the Phillips Villas or any home in the Villages, give me a call. 352-809-8723. Gary McAdams, Barbara Anderson Realty, the Villages Realtor.